Now, again, we have the problem here of the washing, which is hanging on like that's far too heavy. So you can bring that down so. Otherwise, it doesn't look like washing hanging on a line at all. That's brought up Granny Smalls a bit, and same with that one. And this one here is a bit heavy, so he comes out slightly, just a tone. That's not too much. And another one here, because you want the continuity of the washing down the line. The print, which I shall show you in a minute, which is what I would call a completely finished print, all this work took best part of 2.5 to 3 hours. So don't rush into your darkroom at 6 o'clock in the evening and expect to have a print ready for the 7 o'clock print battle or something like that, because you won't get it done in time. Bromoil is a time-consuming process, I suppose you could say. I reckon to do a Bromoil thoroughly, and when you time you start, the time you finish takes best part of a whole day. You don't get much change out of that. Now, I haven't got a brush with me small enough for that. I will spot that out with a paintbrush, that little tiny light, which you don't want. This one, you can, if you go over the edge, don't worry about it. Scrub it on and just take it. And you don't want a highlight on the edge of the print. Always a bad thing to have. So, there we are. Let's begin to shave that one. And, of course, we've got an unfortunate... well, I've got a piece of harder rubber here, which is probably better. All these things are cut to size, especially for me. And then I rub all this out here to bring up the highlight. But this is an ordinary pencil rubber. But you've got to work on it before your print gets too dry. Otherwise you'll find that your ink tends to stay put, and it's a hell of a job to get it off. This print has been drying now for, 4 or 5 hours, and I rather reckon that I would consider it to be slightly too dry. But if you rub it hard, you needn't worry about going through the paper or anything silly like that. You won't never do that. Although it's a single weight paper, I've never yet found any problem going through a Bromoil. Again, where are we? Oh yes, we want to get down to here and clean that shadow up there. All these are questions of little tones which you put in after. And when I've finished, I always spray my prints with a spray which I buy from Winsor & Newton's for fixing watercolours and fixing drawings and things like that. And although a lot of people don't like it and say that a Bromoil should be perfectly matte, I don't see why the hell it should be. Personally, I like my Bromoils to be just that little bit shiny. Not what I would call a full shiny surface or anything of that nature, that's too much. But something of half and half. You've got to be careful, of course, when you do this, you've got to put your hand on there, because if you don't, the thing will ruck up and you get a great crease in your paper, then you might as well pack it up and throw it away. I might mention that the sternest critic of the people who I occasionally show my Bromoils to is my wife. who is no photographer, but she's, we've been married now for 50-something years, and she's seen a few in the course of her married career, and she takes one look at it and says, tear it up, throw it away. And that's what you get for all your morning's work, unfortunately. But it hasn't happened all that time, but I will say that I do respect what she says, because she does really know what she's talking about. Now, I'm now removing some of the darker stones on here because they're tending to make the thing look a bit muddy. Now, you don't want, when you do a thing like that, you don't want a great big black blob there. It's no good to you. So you, what you do with your rubber, you just pull it out, bearing in mind that all you've got is paper base underneath. And if you do that, you will finish up with the stone not there at all, which is a good thing. Same with all these little tiny spots and things. I'm afraid I'm not a clean worker as far as black and white's concerned. I know jolly well I never do anything else with Bromoil, so spots on the print and on the negative and hairs on the negative don't worry me the least, because they just come out when I do the Bromoil. And that's... Now, you see, we begin to clean that up a bit, not clean enough yet. All these want to come out, and it wants to be cleaner, it wants to be whiter. Because the whole object of this thing was to get the balance of the highlights on here standing up against the background. So, again, here, all along here, we should just scrub away, taking all those little bits out, all the annoying bits that you don't like the look of, and then you finish up. Hopefully, an hour or so later, with a print that you like the look of. That's beginning to brighten that up a bit, you see. Now we've got to brighten these steps up a bit more, you see, they're not shining enough. So you just scrub the ink away a bit, and bring the highlight up on those a bit. We can now go back to our original wall here and can get a nice clean edge, which is what you would get, of course. And down here as well. Now you've got to bear in mind that this is doing it very roughly, but merely to try and show the advantages of a particular process. Right, well, having looked at that, there's one or two points that I find that are not entirely satisfactory. And what I'm going to use now is a knife. And I'm going to turn the print over slightly, and I'm going to put a highlight in all the way up this rope that's hanging up the washing. But this, I must tell you, this has got to be done with a very, very sharp knife. When you're scraping with this sharp knife, you are actually removing part of the gelatine, or the ink. Now those are obviously being scraped off the paper, and you will find, before you spray it, you must hold it up and look at it, make quite sure that they're all been taken off the paper, otherwise you'll find it'll finish up like Granny's fur coat. Right, now what you then do is do that with it. you won't affect the print, don't worry about that. And you'll get all those little tiny tiddly bits off, the hold it up to the light, make quite sure they're all off, and then you can start thinking about spraying it. So you have a good look at it. I'm not dissatisfied with this one. I think it's got it has the merit of being in the permanent collection of the Royal, so it can't be too bad. Somebody must have liked it. This is the same print 3 hours later, and I don't think I can do anything more to it now. I've stuck it on a card, as you can see, and also it's been sprayed, which tends to bring the shadows up a little bit and protects the print, because they do get scraped occasionally and you get the ink coming off the print. Well, we've been into all the salient points of the Bromoil process, I think, and I sincerely hope that you've enjoyed it, and that well, you go out and do likewise and improve on what you see.
That Norman Gryspeerdt is a master of the Bromoil process, there can be no doubt. He classifies himself as a specialist in an artistic craft. Most would nominate him as a Bromoil artist par excellence.
It's not difficult, and you will have, I can assure you, great fun.